Well, Chicago's Thanksgiving Day Parade is just getting underway, and this year the Grand Marshal is actress and Chicago native Jennifer Beals.
Jennifer was nice enough to swing by our studio for just a couple of minutes because I know you've got to get back out there to that parade. I said, how are you doing this?
She's like, I've got to get back out to start layering.
Yeah,
I've
that's true.
I've got to get my thermals on. That's what I've got to do.
Oh, my God. You must be really excited to be back home. You're doing a new show here in Chicago, and it's called the Chicago Code.
That's right.
And you play a police officer, right?
I play the police officer.
Yeah, superintendent,
right?
You are. Wow. You wouldn't want the superintendent's headaches here in Chicago,
no,
the real one, right?
I would not, definitely.
So you grew up around here. What part of town did you grow up in?
Kind of everywhere. I started on the south side, 82nd and Indiana, and then we moved north to the north side, so kind of all around town.
Yeah, so what's it like to be able to not only to come home, but also to do a show about where you grew up? That has to be kind of weird.
It's actually really exciting because I get to refamiliarize myself with the city in a way that I certainly wouldn't have been familiar with when I was a young woman. You know, because the show tackles corruption in politics and corruption on the street, and I get to see parts of the city that I never would have seen as a young woman.
What do you think it is about growing up in Chicago and being a Chicagoan that allows you to play this role so effectively?
Well, I feel very proud of my city. I feel, you know, I've lived all over the world, and wherever I go, I really feel like a Chicagoan. And I have a lot of pride and a lot of happy memories of the city. And I think for me to play the superintendent, I really do feel like I want to take care of my city. And I want to take care of the people of the city. And I want to take care of the officers who take care of us.
Is there a Chicago attitude when you have to, when you put yourself into that character? That you have to bring on?
Well,
I mean, do we have like a Chicago attitude? I don't even know.
Well, there's a sound, definitely. There's, you know, the caps. There's like a sound. West Side.
Yeah.
These dems and those.
A little bit, yeah, that I go to when I play the part. But there's a combination of toughness and a sense of humor that's part of the city. Like, you know, we culturally have one of the, you know, I think the most beautiful modern city in the world, but there's a toughness and a sense of humor that I think other cities don't have that combination.
Fact, I know we have some pictures with you and Governor Quinn there. I see you're in uniform.
Yes, that was on set.
I know. Are you wearing a real flak jacket on that with the heavy gear and everything?
I do my best. But as superintendent, too, I'm doing a lot of political work. So I'm not always in the full gear. Yeah. But it's been a lot of fun. And I've met so many really great people. And the guys and gals in the Chicago Police Department have been amazing. And I am just filled with respect for them.
Yeah, and awe, and the work that they do.
Oh,
yeah.
I was
on the
last 30 seconds on the screen.
It's a good thing to play one on TV, right?
Yes, definitely.
Let's talk about the parade underway now. I know there's going to be some special banners in front of your carriage.
Yes, yes. I have two banners in front of my carriage. One is for the Matthew Shepard Foundation, which was founded in 1998 by Dennis and Judy Shepard in memory of their son Matthew, who was murdered in an anti-gay hate crime, and they've created a foundation that does advocacy work and educational work, and they have a terrific website called matthewsplace.com where young people can go to find information and support.
Oh, that's great.
It's really fantastic. You know, really their mandate is to replace hate with understanding and compassion and acceptance, because I think now at this time there's too many people feel comfortable with hate speech. It's become too commonplace and acceptable, and it's not okay, and we've got to change that. And I think as we go into the holidays, people start thinking more and more about community, and I think we also have to take responsibility for the words that come out of our mouths, because we are all connected. And we're all part of one community.
Well, Jennifer Beals, it's great to have you with us this morning on this Thanksgiving. Happy Thanksgiving to you.
Thank you.
And your family.
Thank you.
And I can't wait for the show.
It's
starts in February.
Yes. All right.